The uproars of the people, the great commotion, the public outrage, the anger, what's going on in this city and in this country, it is written in the Word of God. We have to go back to the Word of God and look for counsel and understanding, because someone asked me, Brother Chaarawtazar, in this climate, the scripture says, no man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life. So what should we do? When there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people, then shall thou well understand that the Highest spake of those things. This is what we must understand. Then shall thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the very beginning. Before this fourth beast, this kingdom came into rulership, God spoke about in the end of the world, there would be earthquakes and uproars of the people, nation rising against nation. But we need to go look into the word uproar so we can deal with strategy. See, people are protesting, but man needs to deal with strategy. And they need to look at the battle from the Highest perspective, from the point where you can look at the central intelligence. Because God declared the ending in the beginning and the beginning in the ending. The word uproar is a public expression of protest and outrage. Are we seeing it? Yes, we are. It means commotion, outcry, and furor. A chaos. A situation in which a lot of people are complaining about something. So we're in the situation. A lot of people are complaining about the abuses of government and how the black man has been treated in this country, in America. They're in the most richest and affluent country upon the planet Earth. They are known for systematic patterns of abuse, and it's been going on for hundreds of years. Where they have heard the crying, they've heard the pain, they've seen footage, they've seen the evidence, but they're not stopping. But God said, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people, then shall thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things that from before, even from the very beginning, before this kingdom came in. That is 2 Ezra chapter 9, verse 4. So let's look at this. We're going to talk about strategy, what action we should take, because the captain of salvation has already declared the word. We're going to go into the book of Isaiah and look at the word that God gave to Isaiah, because God declared the ending in the beginning and the beginning in the ending, and you can take comfort. So I want to say grace and peace to you, brothers and sisters. So the grace and peace is from God the Father and from our Lord Jesus Christ. Grace showing that God is putting you in consciousness of his what? His unmerited, his divine assistance, that he's going to assist you in this world, in this life, all that turn to him. Man has to stop being so reactive and being responsive, and man has to deal with the word that declared the happening before it happened. That's why you got to walk by faith and not by sight. You have to look at the word and see as things develop so that there would be no panic, no irrational decisions, so we can know what to do and we can stand in God's counsel. So let's get into it. Let's look into the word of God, because the word of God is light for your soul. It's healing for your soul, it's comfort. And what does it do? It gives you peace, it gives you understanding, it gives you enlightenment, and it shows you what you need to do and what action you need to take. Because people are moving around, they're in commotions, they're in chaos, they're in outcries, they're in public expression of protest and outrage. But what should they do? We got to go into the strategy of the Word of God, and we're going to bring it out by the grace of God and by the love of Christ today. Now, let's go to 2 Ezra chapter 9, and let's deal with the state of the affairs. We're going to look around and see that this has already been assessed. 2 Ezra chapter 9, verse 1. He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself, and when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the Highest will begin to visit the world which he made. It says the Highest will begin to visit the world that he made. See, because God made this world. Man didn't make this world. Man is a resident on the earth that God made, in the beauty of his creation. And man is not walking in the uprightness and the care, although he has dominion and he has an authority. Now, let's go here to Ecclesiastes 5. That's right next to Proverbs, Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 8. It said, then shall the Highest begin to visit the world which he made. Man is responsible to answer to him that made him. Now, Ecclesiastes 5, verse 8. If thou seest the oppression of the poor, and the violent perverting of judgment and justice in the province, marvel not at the matter. Meaning, don't become perplexed. When God said don't marvel at the matter, don't become perplexed. Don't become confused. Don't go into the amazement. Don't be discouraged. Don't be thrown off. Don't be stunned. Marvel not at the matter, for he that is higher than the highest. And what must be understood is that there's higher than the highest. Meaning man looks at presidencies and governments, but God wants man upon the earth that's coming to God to understand that there is he that is higher than the highest. Man is looking at the physical rulers, the visible rulers. Christ came to open up the view and make it clearer. He said, you wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against spiritual wickedness in high places, against the rulers of darkness of this world. This is what the Lord is showing man, that there's more to it than meets the eye. So therefore, you need to step into the enlightenment of the word so you can get the proper direction in life. There is higher than the highest. And that requires for a man to pray so he cannot be so responsive in the flesh. Okay. For he that is higher than the highest regardeth, and there be higher than they. Moreover, the prophet of the earth is for all. The king himself is served by the few. So the Lord told us, the prophet of the earth is for all. Although we're seeing the oppression of the poor and the violent perverting of judgment, the Lord is telling you the prophet of the earth is for all. So the earth is in an uproar because they see they're not profiting. They're seeing the abuses. They're seeing the cruel and the unfair treatment. People are looking clearly at how black people in America have been treated. How they've been systematically disenfranchised after the Emancipation Proclamation, which should have guaranteed the rights of all black people, the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendment, to how the Jim Crow laws that were put in and the black codes, right? There's many of them that's still operating in violation of the Constitution that America said they're standing on. That the towns were burned. The Red Summer. The 1967 riots, which was a long, hot summer. You can look these things up, brothers and sisters. The Red Summer of 1919. The long, hot summer of 1967. You can look, and there's many riots. The Atlanta riot and massacre of 1906. This was all because the states rejected and hated that the slaves were given rights 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendment, and they made moves to stop the prosperity of black people in this country and burned up their businesses town by town, city by city. Not just Tulsa, Oklahoma. Not just Elaine, Arkansas. Not just Wilmington, North Carolina. Not just Rosewood. Not just Hayti. Not just Durham. Many, many towns. Buffalo, all over this country. Hundreds and hundreds of towns were burned up and thousands and thousands and thousands of houses were destroyed. So you could understand. So you see in the oppression. Now God has it where we see the uproars of the people. Now let's go to 2 Ezra. Let's go back there. Because they didn't respect that the prophet of the earth is for all. So when the black people came to profit in this country and the white saw it, the Anglo-Saxons, the Dutch, the French, the Spanish, the Germans, because those were the early settlers. What they did, they saw the blacks prospering, and they brought in other Eastern Europeans. They brought in other Europeans. That's where you get the word, watch those honkies. That was white-on-white racism. The Anglo-Saxon whites were calling the new immigrants that was brought into this country by proverbs and insulting names. They call the Italians guineas. They call the Hungarians honkies. And they call the Polish immigrants Polacks. Because they were, and what they did, they created the tension for them to be accepted into the white society. They had to agree with the white hatred of black people. This is facts of American history. So we're seeing the violent perverting of judgment and the uproars of the people because now the nakedness has been uncovered that America has not changed. They give a little bit here and a little bit here, but there's a lot of invisible evils that they're doing, meaning stuff they're not talked about, people are not complaining, and now it's out. The videos and what's being shown from Rodney King, has it stopped? you know it hasn't stopped. As we look into the matters of our day and see that everything that's going on, it is in the Word of God, and the Word of God is relevant. The Word of God is significant and has demonstrable bearing upon the matters at hand, and it will give you insight. It will give you strategy. It will let you know what you need to do and what actions you need to take. You don't have to be erratic. You don't have to be rash. You don't have to have disproportionate anger. See, when God said be angry but sin not, meaning make sure you don't step out of the wisdom. So let's be clear. Let's look to the Word of God. And I want to say grace and peace to all my brothers and sisters. Thank you for tuning in today. And we're going to go into the Word of God and look for counsel and strategy in these days. People are protesting, people are angry and upset, but we're dealing with strategy because the captain of our salvation and God our Father have left us strategy. He said it is written. He declared the ending in the beginning and the beginning in the ending. And he's going to prove to all mankind that his word is true, his word is exact, and he saw this day before it came. So all we got to do is walk in the faith. We don't have to be reactive. We don't have to be responsive. We don't have to wait for things to happen to try to figure out what to do. We can deal with the learning. That is why Christ said, take my yoke and learn of me. I came to give you divine lessons from the Father to guide you while you are upon the earth. 2 Ezra chapter 9, we're talking about the uproars of the people. We're talking about strategy. We're talking about what actions you need to take. We're talking about what man must understand. You got to keep yourself in the love of God because God has included you in his plan for salvation and deliverance and light and help and future and paradise and immortality and success and profit. And to show you how to navigate, how to move, how to operate, how to gain mastery in this day. The Word of God gives you skill and understanding. And this is a day where a man needs skill and understanding. Okay, 2 Ezra chapter 9 verse 1. He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. And when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made. We discussed in the previous class about Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 8. When thou seest the oppression of the poor and the violent perverting of judgment. That is what we're seeing. We're seeing the oppression, the cruel and unfair treatment of the poor in this country, of my people, of us, and the violent perverting of judgment. It says, he that is in a province, do not marvel at the matter. Meaning, don't let it put you into a state of shock and paralyze your thinking. It said, but he that is higher than the highest regardeth, and they be higher than they. Meaning, you have to look at the highest power now. You have to look beyond presidents, look beyond armies, and look to God. And that's how it's set up. You have to walk by faith now. You have to go into the written word, and not by sight, and not be so reactive. Let's go into the word. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people. So we do see the uproars. We see the public expressions of protest and outrage and commotion. The outcry, the furors, the outrage, the chaos, the unrestrained disorder. We see a situation in which a lot of people are complaining about what's going on angrily and shouting. Okay, we're reading the uproars. 2 Ezra chapter 9. We're at verse 3. Now verse 4. Then shalt thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. So the Most High spake of those things. So it's supposed to bring you into a deeper learning. I mean, that's written? Yeah, it's written. That's in the Bible? Yeah, that's in the Bible. Well, what else does it say? And we got to deal with, since the uproars of the people are here and the protests of the people are here, what else does it say? Well, we can look at what else it says going to happen. Because the spirit of Jesus Christ is a spirit of prophecy. And what's going to stand is what Christ showed us in prophecy, because he's the seeing. He's what makes vision possible. So the Lord said, don't marvel at the matter. It said, then shalt thou well understand. This is the time where we're supposed to well understand, not panic, not feel despair. This is a time where you can have hope. You know what to look forward to because you see the word is coming to pass. The word is true. The word is written. Okay. Then shalt thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. For like as all things that are made in the world have a beginning and an end, and the end is manifest. So America, the 13 colonies were established. When they broke away from Great Britain. Because, and in the Declaration of Independence, they showed the reasons why they broke away. They were being abused. They were experiencing unfair and cruel treatment. They complained. The 13 colonies saw that England was oppressing them. They were cruel. They were unfair. They were abusive. They didn't care about them. And no matter how much they pleaded, the abuse and the injuries continued. Now, that was the beginning of this country, where they established their Declaration of Independence. Now, they have done the same thing that they complained that the English and the British were doing to them, to us, to black people in this country for over 400 years. So now we see the ending. The nakedness is being uncovered. Now they are the abusers again. They are wicked oppressors. Wicked oppressors because they know that people are being hurt and they don't care. They're not changing. Now this complaint is coming up before the Most High because God tell you in the end of the world, the kingdom that was going to be ruling when he came, when Christ came, the kingdom was going to be dealing with the people with much wicked oppression. For like as all that is made in this world hath a beginning and an end, and the end is manifest, its evident is clear to be seen. Even so the times also of the highest have plain beginnings and wonders and powerful works and endings and effects and signs. Now you look at people, they were protesting in Berlin about the evil that was going on here to the blacks. A vibration of feeling, people are feeling convicted about their indifference to how the blacks are being treated in this country. Because what they're going to come to find out that you abuse the children of the living God. That they abuse the children of Israel. That they abuse the children of promise. They abused the children of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. They're going to come to this full awareness that they played the part of Pharaoh and they were abusing the children of God. Although the middle wall of partition was broken down and Christ came in Ephesians chapter 2 of twain, making one new man, so making peace that everybody after the blood of Christ was supposed to become a man of love, and kindness, and integrity, and justice, and peace, and goodness, and care, and charity, and compassion, and pity. Man was supposed to become that kind of man. Because Christ's blood gave man a life to live. And that life is a life of care and love, where every member on the earth, every member of mankind, of the human race, was supposed to have the same care one of another. The blood of Christ brought man into that love. Now, and everyone that shall be saved shall be able to escape by the works and by faith whereby ye have believed, shall be preserved from the said perils, and shall see my salvation in my land and within my borders. So everyone that's going to be saved, this is a time for man should look to be saved, to see the salvation and in the borders, to see Christ come and see the new heaven and see the new earth and see Christ rule in the great glory of the Father. Now, see the resurrection. See the eternal life. See what eyes have not seen and ears have not heard. Man should be looking forward to the blessed kingdom, the heavenly city. Because God said, I prepared for them a city. God is not ashamed to be called their God, as it says in Hebrews chapter 11. For I have sanctified them for me from the beginning. So those that are with the word of God, God has sanctified them. He called them into the spirit of love. He imputed his spirit to them. And the spirit of God is a spirit of love and care. And that love is without partiality. And that love is without hypocrisy. And that love is gentle. And that love is pure. And that love is unfeigned. And that love is without dissimulation. And that love works no ill to their neighbors, to their brothers, to their sisters, to no one upon the earth. Because, and that love does not work ill to anyone upon the planet earth. Because in that love, there's a consciousness that God said, he had made of one blood all families of men to dwell upon the face of the earth. Man is supposed to be treated in the dignity wherein God has made him. In the honor, that's why the scripture said, honor all men. Okay. For I have sanctified them for me from the beginning. Then shall they be in pitiful case which now have abused my ways, and they that have cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torments. For such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me. See, what is God saying? If you receive benefits, you were shown love and you seen beauty and you seen experienced marriage and peace and people serving you. But did you come to know God? Did you come to know that God was love and equitable and peace and righteous and just and fair and kind and merciful and long-suffering and good? I need an answer. How does this end? Sometimes people feel fear because they don't know what's happening. They don't understand. So to come out of the fear, because the scripture says God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. That's 2 Timothy chapter 1. When God has given you power and love and a sound mind, because it takes power and love to bring you to the sound mind. This is beyond the letters. You need power and love to be brought to the sound mind, because it takes power to have faith. It takes power to have belief. It takes power to meditate. It takes power to believe. So when Christ said and had Paul teach Timothy, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind, so we can be settled in this day. Now, all over America, they're seeing disillusionment. Disillusionment is disappointment in someone or something that one discovers to be less good than one had believed. Disappointed and unhappy because of discovering the truth about something or someone that you liked and respected. A feeling of disappointment, akin to depression, arising from the realization that something is not what it was expected or believed to be. So people have seen that the American government and the police department is not what people expected or believed them to be. Look at this here. So we're seeing in the public outrage disillusionment. A feeling of disappointment akin to depression, arising from the realization that something, America is not what was expected to be, possibly accompanied by psychological angst from having one's beliefs challenged, having lost faith or trust in something. So many people have lost faith and trust. So they're protesting, they said it's gotta change. They don't trust the police department, they don't trust the judges, because the innocent projects showed that the sentences that was handed down disproportionately to blacks, it was a lot of innocent people were convicted. Mm-hmm. And it's proven. So there's great disillusionment in this country. Disappointed that something is not as good or as valuable as you thought. Disappointed by making the person realize the unpleasant truth. So many people are facing and realizing the unpleasant truth about how this country has used systematic racism on black people and did not change, even though their constitution demanded it should be done. That the judges and the legislature of this country did not uphold their own constitution. And that the states that were given rights under the 15th Amendment to execute and to enforce the rights of every citizen, they disenfranchised the blacks, and the blacks have been defrauded and been abused. And it hasn't stopped. And now the nakedness is uncovered, people are seeing it plain. No. Because in this time, brothers and sisters, with the protests and the uproars of the people, there must be strategy. There must be a strategy that you must take. It's in the Word of God. Strategy is a careful plan and method. A clever stratagem. An adaptation and complex adaptations of behavior. So what are the complex adaptations of behavior that man must take? That's what Christ said, you got to be born again. Meaning man has to come out of the spirit of vanity that he's in, of pride that he's in, of hatred that he's in, of selfishness that is in, of the lust of the eye, the lust of the flesh, the pride of his life. He has to come out of that. He has to come out of those patterns of behavior and come into the adaptations. He has to change the way he's operating and living. People are saying, yes, we should take our money and support black businesses. Yes, we should. We should have been doing that a long time ago. Because they're supposed to be social cohesion. You're supposed to have to care one of another. But what the Lord is showing us from 1 Corinthians chapter 1, in order for you to have healing amongst the people, the members of that nation must see each other as a body, members of a body. And you see each other as a member of a body. It says no man ever hated his own flesh. We have to see one another as Christ taught us that no man ever hated his own flesh. It said, but he nourished it and cherished it as Christ the church. Meaning you have to nourish it. You have to inspire it. You have to teach it. You have to care for it. And the first care that man must be in is the care of his mind. Because all over the world, the movements that we're seeing upon the earth, everything you see manifest physically is a demonstration of a word. A word the man is executing or believe. That's why he took that hateful action, or that's how he took the action of love. It's all the manifestation of a word. And God do not want his people, his saints, them that believe in him, or mankind upon the earth, to be deceived by other men's words. That's why he sent the word down from heaven. That's why I said his name is called the Word of God, meaning he's giving us the word, the direction, meaning that's what we should think about. What did Jesus say? That's a direction for healing for people. Whether you be Jew or Greek, bond or free, male or female, meaning that's the word for you, the word of righteousness, the word of care, the word of faith, the word of love, the word of your creator. The word of love, the word of righteousness, the word of peace, the word of forgiveness, the word of kindness, the word of compassion. That is the word that man needs to be in. Or how are you going to be a family? If we're going to deal with the warfare, we have to deal with the warfare. The warfare is against your family. So each family must stop the destructiveness going on amongst themselves. How do you change that? How do you change your behavior? You got to change your mind. That's why Christ said, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. How do you change your mind? By what? By increasing in knowledge. That's why the scripture says, grow in grace and in the knowledge of the Son of God, because the knowledge of the Son of God has to overwrite the other knowledge and the word that was in your mind that created the bad behavior, that created the dysfunctional behavior, that created the envy or the strife or the bitterness. You have to overwrite, you have to renew your mind. Education is the key. See, the divine education is the key for man to step up and to actually move as a body, because it was false teaching and lies that made people fight against each other. Christ said that Satan, when he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own. For he is the liar and the father of it. God is not a man that he should lie. God don't lie to man. He's telling you exactly what's going on. He's giving everybody the right direction. Man got to believe the word. That God already saw this day. That's why you got food on the planet Earth. Because God prepared the food. It's just coming up out of the earth. He already had the animals created before man was born. The sun is not being made. The sun been in the sky before man was born. The moon and the stars, the seasons, it was all prepared before man was born. God already prepared his word. And in different times, he sent his word into the earth through inspired prophets. These are all holy words to give man direction in his time. Because God knows that man needs knowledge. He needs inside information. He needs exclusive intelligence in order for him to make the right action and to make the right decision. That's why it says God is a God of knowledge. And by him, actions are weighed. So man should be a man of knowledge so we can weigh our own actions. You don't have to look to somebody else for strategy. It is already written. So Paul is telling Timothy what to do. He said, thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. Meaning, do not look at the battle and become discouraged. Don't become disillusioned. Be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. That the Lord saw this day and now he's going to guide you through it. Okay. You don't have to be disillusioned. No, you don't have to be disillusioned. You don't have to be there. You don't have to be disappointed to the point that you go into angst or despair. You don't have to be there. No. You can be wise. You can be in the know. You don't have to feel disappointed because you realize the unpleasant truth. Because many people become disillusioned when they realize the unpleasant truth. For example, the white churches have been shown to be total hypocrites because they abandoned the social justice. Why? Because they were showing public protests to what Martin Luther King said. That's what they did to this day. That's what they did. They are in full consciousness that the American judicial system has been in violation of their own constitution. They're well aware. They're aware of the racism going on with the police departments and the jobs, and they're aware of the redlining and what the banks did, but they sat silent because as long as they got their money, as long as they got what they want, they don't care about nobody else, so they did not love their neighbor as they loved themselves. That's a problem. They're going to face the judgment because they had the world's good. See, people think they're so quick to get the world's good, but he to have the world's goods and see his brother have need. And shutteth up the bowels of compassion against him, how dwelleth the love of God in him. And if you say you love God whom you have not seen, and how can you say you love God whom you have not seen, and you hate man, your brother whom you have seen? Showing you don't love God. You're just playing religion. This is serious. Man is called to repent and step into the love and step into the righteousness and overwrite the corrupt program of his mind and actions and behaviors that was given to him by false teachers and false ministers and by the curriculum of the education in the system. Man was educated to deal with envy, malice, strife, bickering, grudges, stealing, defrauding. That is not being educated. To be educated, you have to come into integrity. You have to come into the highest standards and codes of conduct. To be educated, you must come where you are in the uncompromising adherence to what is right and resisting evil. You have to be educated. And don't be compromising about it. To be educated, you have to come to the education of the knowledge of the Son of God. Because when Christ came into this world, the Greeks were not educated. The Romans were not educated. Christ said, all sinning came short of the glory of God. He told the Pharisees that you were deceived, that they were blind guides. So who saw? Who was educated? Only the disciples that heard Christ and saw the way that he showed man to live, to be converted and to come into the love and to come into the gospel of the kingdom of heaven. That is what the education was. Because the kingdoms of men had men operating with each other with indignation, with wrath and anger and strife and seeking their own. Is that love don't seek its own. It's not puffed up. It vaunteth not itself. It does not behave unseemly. See, the Christian word, the godly word, the holy word makes you not behave unseemly. Is that it doesn't do evil. It rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth. So all those clan meetings and all that evil that was done, those were not Christian people at all. They were deceived. They were just as wicked as the Pharisees. A generation of vipers enjoyed the destruction of who didn't agree with them. But they themselves were in disobedience to the love of God. And the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others also. Thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who have chosen him to be a soldier. And if a man also strive for masteries, yet is he not crowned except he strive lawfully. So no man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him that have chosen him to be a what? To be a soldier. I mean, a soldier, you know who enlisted you. A soldier understands the battle. A soldier understands that he's wrestling not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against spiritual wickedness in high places, against the rulers of darkness of this world. A soldier sees the enemy. A soldier also sees who has been compromised by the enemy. A soldier sees when somebody's been paid off by the enemy. A soldier sees when someone's being tempted by the enemy. And a soldier must also, what does the scripture say? Keep himself in the love of God. Because it's a highly satanic world that we are in. Soldiers have to be there. Soldiers got to go in for a checkup to make sure that they're spiritually healthy. That's what God said. Examine yourself, whether you be in the faith. Prove your own self. I mean, you got to check on yourself. Soldiers also got to be humble, because somebody might have to wash your feet and remind you or reprove you. Not upbraid you, because God doesn't deal with the upbraiding. But to be a soldier, you must understand the battle landscape was going on the planet Earth. You must understand it. Like if you see the municipalities in this country, they've all been tempted with evil. That's why they move so dark and they don't move in the light. The soldier must understand that. A soldier must understand not to get caught up in the commotion. A soldier must understand he can't get caught up in the public outrage and the expression of furor and outcry and the situation where a lot of people are confused about. A soldier understands what's going on. A soldier is well informed. Why? Because he knows who enlisted him. God called us to be soldiers of the Lord Jesus Christ. It said, "Be you are bought with a price. Be not ye the servants of men. Ye are bought with a price, Christ's blood." Meaning that's the life that's supposed to be guiding your mind and your actions and your decision. Be not ye the servants of men. Do not be brought into a cult. Don't be brought into a cult where man is controlling the way you think. No, make sure you stay in the word. And stay in the righteous and try the spirit, by the spirit, whether it be of God. God is a loving spirit. You know that already. God is dealing with righteousness. God is dealing with equity. As you have men do to you, do ye even unto them. This is the law and the prophets. You're dealing with God now. Every member should have the same care one for another. What you do to your brothers, you should do faithfully to the Gentiles or to other nations. So you know that God is dealing with equity and fairness. You got to be clear. God is not dealing with dishonest gain. God is not dealing with man that's working ill to their neighbor. God is not dealing with guile or dissimulation and putting on false appearances. God is not dealing with backbiting and whispering and talking behind people's back and adultery and fornication. It's been revealed what God is for and what he's against. Romans chapter 1 shows you what God is against. And when man moves against the love and the care of God, that's why the wrath of God comes upon him. And the wrath of God is divine chastisement so that man would change.
Brothers and sisters, I want to tell you thank you for this walking and looking at the uproars of the people together. Be wise, be circumspect, redeeming the time, for the days are evil. May the Lord keep you in this day, keep you strong, keep you wise, keep you prudent, fill you with all wisdom and knowledge and understanding, and give you strength of mind and body, and heal you, and cure you, and bless you, and give you peace, and comfort you on every side. The day of salvation is at hand, as you grow in grace, and in the knowledge of the Son of God. But I have to put out by the grace of the Lord Jesus about the uproars of the people so we can move in the realm of being soldiers. Grace and peace. I want to tell you thank you and bless you to the supporters, to the believers, to the saints that's carrying the light in their life and living the truth of the gospel of Christ. Blessed are your eyes that see and your ears that hear. Hit the bell, brothers and sisters. Subscribe, be blessed, be wise, live, walk in the fruits of the Spirit. Amen. A very special thank you to you, brothers and sisters, that are supporting the ministry. And we ask you to join us on Tuesdays, 7:30 to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for a conference call if you have any questions. And subscribe to the YouTube channels, Risen with Christ on YouTube Ministries and Born Again Israelite Ministries. The Lord bless you and keep you and let your light shine. Eat Christ's flesh, drink his blood, and live the glory of his majesty, walking in the divine love, walking in the freedom that is in Christ Jesus.
This song is to remind you of the winner within. Regardless of what you see, regardless of what you heard, you are a conqueror. You are the head and not the tail, above and not beneath, the first and not the last. You are a conqueror, a conqueror, a conqueror.
I have a power
over the enemy.
Over the enemy.
No weapon formed against thee
shall prosper against me.
Greater is he
that is within me.